Hey, fellow scientists. Well, what do you think? I made these planters myself out of old tires. I thought my garden could use a bit of upcycling charm. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to explain the meaning of the phrase reduce, reuse, recycle, and identify some ways you can implement it yourself. Let's get into it. In our previous lessons, we've talked about some pretty serious topics like pollution, the consequences of not conserving resources, and the effects of our actions on the environment. Today, we're switching gears a bit. We're going to explore some of the best ways individuals could keep our planet healthy, the three R's. The three R's are reduce, reuse, and recycle. And they're all about how we can lower the amount of waste that ends up in landfills, or worse, polluting the environment. Let's take a deep dive into what each of these mean. The first R, reduce, means to cut down on the amount of waste we generate. It's the first of the three R's because it's the method that has the most impact on decreasing waste. The best way to prevent waste is to just not create it in the first place. Reducing is all about making mindful choices that help create less waste. For example, a big way to reduce is by avoiding single-use or disposable items. Instead of drinking from a plastic water bottle that probably won't be used again once it's empty, opt for a bottle that can be refilled over and over. This means the number of water bottles being used is reduced. The same goes for shopping with a reusable bag instead of the single-use bags available at checkout. Choosing reusable options instead of disposable options reduces waste. Reducing can also look like just using less. Turning off the lights when leaving a room or turning off the water while brushing your teeth does a lot to conserve resources. Getting those resources to where they're going takes a lot of energy, and as we know, energy production is a big cause of pollution. Reducing the resources consumed creates less pollution. Have you ever worn hand-me-down clothes or borrowed a book from the library instead of buying a new one? That's also reducing. What other ways have you reduced before? Pause the video here and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Of course, you can only reduce so much. Most things you'll never be able to reduce down to zero, and that's okay. Once you've reduced all you can, the next best thing you can do is reuse. If you already have something, like a plastic bag, then you can't exactly reduce it to make less of it. So the second best thing you can do is reuse it. Reusing means to use something more than once. In the case of that plastic bag, that means using it in the next time you go out shopping or for something else, like picking up your dog's waste. Reusing can also look like making use of things for as long as possible instead of throwing them away. For example, if a shirt doesn't fit anymore, it can be given to a friend or donated to charity. Or the reverse, instead of buying something brand new, it can be bought used or secondhand. Anything that prevents the item from ending up in a landfill is beneficial to the planet. Reusing can also mean finding new uses for things and giving them a second life. For example, once tires are too worn to be used on cars, they can instead be reused to make soft playground surfaces. Or those tires can be turned into planters, like what I did, giving those tires a new use. You'll often hear this type of reuse called upcycling, which means to give an old object new purpose or value. People can get very creative with how they reuse items to prevent them from becoming waste. Shipping pallets can be reused as furniture, plastic bottles can be turned into eco-bricks that have a variety of uses, and candy wrappers can even be made into purses and jewelry. Give it a go by trying yourself. How might you reuse this yogurt container once it's empty? Pause the video here and record your thoughts in your guided notes. The last of the three R's is recycling. The most effective ways to protect the environment and prevent waste are to reduce and reuse anything you can before finally recycling. To learn more about why that is, let's take a deeper look at how recycling works. To recycle means to transform waste into new objects. Let's see what this looks like by following the journey of a used soda can. Instead of throwing the can away, it's rinsed and placed in a recycling bin, where it'll be collected and taken to a recycling center. At the center, the can will be carefully sorted, so it's only with other pieces of aluminum. All the aluminum is then crushed into tiny pieces, then melted into molds to create new products. What was once your soda can could become part of a bicycle, a car, or even an airplane. Materials like aluminum, glass, paper, and some plastics can be recycled, but not everything can. It's important to check product labels and the rules for recycling in your area for what can be recycled. As you can see, recycling is a very powerful tool. It prevents many products from ending up in a landfill. As you also may have noticed, each step of the process, from the truck picking up the recycling to the processing at the recycling center, consumes energy, which is something we're trying to minimize. That's why recycling should always come after you've reduced and reused as much as you can. Let's review everything we've learned today. Reduce, reuse, recycle is a phrase that describes how individuals can help to decrease waste, in order with reducing having the most impact. Reduce means to cut down on the amount of waste generated, and it's the most effective of the three R's. This can look like opting for reusable products over disposable ones and taking measures to use fewer resources. Reuse means to use something more than once. This can look like donating used clothes or upcycling products to give them a new purpose. Recycle means to transform waste into new materials or objects. Recycling prevents waste from going to a landfill, but it takes a lot of energy to do so. It's best to first reduce, then reuse whatever you can before recycling. To learn more about the three R's, be sure to check out the practice questions and activities that go with this lesson. My next upcycling project is complete. Don't let your eyes deceive you. This may look like an ordinary milk jug, but when I tip it over, it's a watering can to go with my new planters. And by reusing this jug, I've given it a second life. And that brings us to the end of the course. I've had so much fun learning with you through it, fellow scientists. Remember, science is all around us. See you next time.